Welcome to Rajasasila Holistics. Today in the Law of Attraction, the final phase I am going to teach you, I think a small recoup I will tell you that Law of Attraction is the very greatest law in the universe to attract and manifest things. In this you have to eliminate your negative feelings and have positive feelings that you can manifest things. And second thing, you have to clear your space, your mind, body and soul, and protect your aura during this session. This has to be done every day. And third thing I have taught you is that you have to be in the state that you have achieved it. Now the final stage, how actually you will be doing the law of attraction process. For this you need a quiet place where you can sit and do the law of attraction manifestation. Take a paper and write whatever you want to manifest. Don't overdo, like jumbling too many problems in one go. Take one by one which you feel the most important one. Take that problem which you want to solve, or take that topic which you want to manifest, either of it, and sit in a quiet place where you can focus and concentrate on yourself and the manifestation process, and sit and write what actually you need. Write it in the positive and affirmative sense, that tense, that I have achieved so and so on this day. You write it clearly without any negative points. Don't say that I am not having this, or I want this, or not in that way. Just you write that I have achieved this and I am very happy about it and I thank the universe for it. So you will be writing that and put your signature there, and when you finish off and keep the pen aside, at that second, at that moment, think that you have achieved it. That's it. If you are going to be in that state of happiness, even initially for even 5 to 10 seconds is enough. Slowly you will gather that feeling, and you can take up to 5 minutes, 10 minutes. It's up to you. However your capacity allows it to you. This is the process which many people have got it, and this is the easiest way of manifesting things. They do this for 45 days to 90 days according to your problem. This is the way of manifesting, guys, that I have taught you. So now I want to tell you, some people are as such that they don't have the inner capacity for manifesting things through law of attraction. For them, I am going, from next week I am going to teach how to manifest through vision board. That is also equally very powerful thing, but for that you don't need the inner capacity or you to meditate and all. For some people who find it difficult, for them that will be very good. Or if you want to do both simultaneously, that also you can do to manifold the power of the law of attraction. So quickly going into the, we will go into the readings. Check the energies for Cancerians this week. If you have not subscribed our channel, kindly subscribe. In the health context, you are getting 6 of Pentacles. Career, business and finances, 10 of Wands. And relationship, you have got 9 of Swords. And this week, I am taking affirmation cards for you. I am willing to learn new things. So in the health context, 6 of Pentacles again reassures you that this is the time that you need to balance your mind and body and soul. This is very important at this time when the world is going through a very lean period. You have to balance your mind and body because of some uncertain things. Mentally you are stressed up, you are not able to focus up on your health, you are at home or you are at job or whatever it is, stress takes up in your mind and that tells upon your health, and unhealthy lifestyle that should be modified. you should give time and prioritize your health. Go for health style regime. Once again, that function you have to do it for dieting. Good food, good sleep, and good lifestyle is very much necessary. And alternatively, we can see that if you have any health issues, that will be sorted out, and your health will come to a balance. That what this card says, we can give 80% positivity in career, business, and finances. 10 of Wands says that you have to put very much on your work front, but what you get out of it will be very less. But you need not worry, guys, because 10 of Wands always says that the process will be hard, but what you get out of it is always good. That's what this card says. We can give 60% positivity, because anytime, anywhere you put hard work, then only you will get good return. So putting hard work is never a wrong thing or bad thing. It's only a good thing. So we can give 60-70% positivity. In the relationship front, 9 of Swords is not a great card to get. This card says that many of you are undergoing some mental stress, or you feel that you have been blamed for something. You are restless, sleepless, not happy. Something is making you feel very bad, ashamed, or some incident has happened which makes you unhappy. That's what this card says. You have to overcome it. Sometimes this what appears to be not, need not be the real one. It may be only an illusionary one that can also be there. So you have to be bold. You have to overcome this stress and think with a different perspective to see the life, how real it is. Don't be in an anticipatory fear. That's what this card says. We can give only 20% positivity. And in affirmation card, this card says that I am willing to learn new things. See, whenever challenges comes in life, whether it is in your workplace where you have to work hard, or whether in your relationship where you feel that things are not working according to you, or you are victimized, or you feel that things are not good, you fear. All these things are challenges in life, which says love to learn, and I am willing to drop old concept where they no longer work for me. Growing and changing is exciting. That's what this card says, that you need to learn. You need to learn new things to invite good things. That's what the universe says, that if you stick to a particular place, particular point, you can't proceed or grow in life. You have to go. You have to learn new things. If you have to go learn new things, you have to move on. So don't stick to one place and brood upon it. Accept changes, new things in life, so that you can grow and you can move on. That's what this card says. Let's see what the Strictomancy has to say. More people rust out than wear out. Because negative things, rather than wearing you out, it rusts you from inside so that you collapse. So you need to be bold so that you can overcome all this negativity and hardships that life sends you, for making you more strong, not to make you rust up. So be bold, guys, and face the challenge.